We have learned that DHCP lists parameters such as IP address, default gateway, DNS to our host or clients automatically. There's no more hard labor of doing manual configuration for our clients or host. But what happens if one of our hosts in our network brings a home router that acts as a switch, a firewall, and a DHCP server, and he connects it in his little cubicle so that he can block more than one device that we allocated him in the network? Or even worse, what happens if a hacker uses a rogue DHCP server on our network? How do we go about securing our network? All of that will be answered in this lesson. Welcome to another exciting episode of Technology for All Academy, an academy that teaches information, communication, technology, networking for free to all. To mention but a few, we have CCNA and MicroTik series, and we'll be doing other vendor series in the future. For those who don't know me, my name is Thabang Makube, the founder of Technology for All Academy. Our topic for today is DHCP snooping. We'll be learning what is DHCP snooping, what attacks does DHCP snooping protect the network against, how does DHCP snooping operate or works, and how to configure DHCP snooping. So what really is DHCP snooping? It's a layer 2 security feature that filters or blocks rogue DHCP server from attacking our network by filtering DHCP messages from untrusted ports. By default, all ports inside the bridge are untrusted. To make an example, I'm going to open my Winbox and show you what I'm talking about. Okay, without any waste of time, let me open the Winbox and then I'll connect to a router that acts as a switch. Okay, now let's go to bridge and then I'll click on ports. Okay, let's open ETH1. And as we can see, the tick box of trusted is not ticked. There's no tick inside and the others are ticked, meaning our port is untrusted. If we want our port to be trusted, we will have to tick the trusted box and then apply or click OK so that the effect will take place. And then as you can see, right now it says the port is trusted. And then I want to show you another thing. If I go to interface and we go to ETH1 again, we can see under ETH1, there's nothing that talks about trusted or anything. So meaning our bridge, it's similar to a switch. Now, what attacks does DHCP snooping protect the network against? It protects the network against DHCP starvation attack and DHCP poisoning attack, which can be used to perform a man-in-the-middle attack. DHCP starvation attack is when an attacker uses spoofed MAC addresses in order to flood discover messages so that the targeted DHCP pool becomes full, resulting in denial of service to other devices in the network. And DHCP poisoning attack is when an attacker replies to DHCP client discover messages by listing them parameters such as IP address, DNS, and default gateway. And it will make itself default gateway for the network. So all the messages that are destined for any clients or any destination will go through the rogue DHCP first. And the attacker can modify the frames as he wishes before he can forward them to the real DHCP server so that they can be transported or transmitted to their final destination. So, how does DHCP snooping operate? Firstly, if DHCP message is received on trusted port, forward it as per normal. And if DHCP message is received on untrusted port, act as follows. If it's a DHCP server message, block or drop the frame. And if it's a DHCP client message, check if the frame source MAC address and the client hardware address field are matching. If they don't match, drop or discard the message. So to show you what I'm talking about, let me open my Winbox and connect to the 10 network. Okay, then I'll go to IP, DHCP server, and then as you can see under list we have MAC address. As you can see, it's ending with 1FBD, and client ID, which is our client hardware address, it also ending with 1FBD. And then also, if I can go to command prompt, let me type cmd so that I can open my command prompt, and I'll give the command ipconfig/all, enter. You can see my MAC address is ending with 1FBD. So my PC got DHCP parameters because of my MAC address and my client hardware ID or client hardware address match. Now for our configuration purposes, I've already configured my legit DHCP server, and as we can see, if I go to DHCP tab, we can see that it's connected on Ethernet 2, and the network that we are leasing is 10.10.1.0 network, and our gateway is 10.10.1.254, which is our MikroTik router. Let me open a new terminal so that I can show you all the things that we did. I have three routers. The other one, it's acting as a switch or a bridge. So let me open the one that's acting as a switch or a bridge. Okay. I'm going to connect. And then as you can see, we have a bridge one. And then the ports that are assigned to bridge one, it's ETH1 to ETH4 and also the wireless LAN 1. But as you can see, wireless LAN is inactive and ETH3 is also inactive. My ETH1 is connected to my legit DHCP server, and my ETH2 is connected to my rogue DHCP server, while my ETH4 is connected to my PC or my client. So I'm going to open new terminal so that I can connect to my last router and configure it as a rogue DHCP server. I'm not gonna connect it to the internet for this purpose or for this practical example, as this is a lab test. But in real world, when you do a man in the middle attack, you have to do it seamlessly so that a client or a host won't be able to see that something wrong is happening on the network, because he'll be getting whatever he's saving or whatever he's trying to get on the network. So without waste of time, let me connect to my router. So to configure the IP address for our rogue DHCP server, I'll go to IP address, and then I'll click on the edition sign. I'll give it 192.168.1.1/24, which is 255.255.255.0, and I'll assign it to Ethernet 2 and click OK. Let me close it. And to create my DHCP server, I'll go to IP, DHCP server, DHCP setup, and DHCP server interface is 2. Yes, DHCP address space 192.168.1.0/24. Yes, address to give out. Yes, I agree. DNS, it's fine, you can make it Google DNS. List time, yes. Setup has completed successfully. Okay. And as you can see, we have our DHCP and it's connected to ETH2. And the network that we are leasing is 192.168.1.0 network. And there's no lease at the moment. So what I'm going to do right now, I'm going to open my Wireshark and I'll connect to my Ethernet port so that I can start capturing packets. So what I'm going to do, let me go to my command prompt and give the command ipconfig /release. Enter. And then I'll give the command ipconfig /renew. Enter. And we can see that we got our IP address from our legit DHCP server. So right now, let me minimize my command prompt and also minimize my Winbox. I'll stop my capture and then let me filter it to DHCP. I'll filter my capture to DHCP. And as we can see, that's our DHCP release message. And then we have a discover message from us going to the destination of 255.255.255.255, which is a broadcast address. And then as we can see, we have offer from 10.10.1.254, and we also have offer from 192.168.1.1, which is our rogue DHCP server. And our request went to the legit DHCP server as we got the acknowledge from 10.10.1.254. And as you saw, the IP address that we got is 10.10.1.253. Okay, let me repeat the process again. Ipconfig /release. Ipconfig /renew. And as we can see right now, we got our DHCP parameters from our rogue DHCP, which is the IP address that we got is 192.168.1.254. And the default gateway is 192.168.1.1. Okay, so now let me minimize my command prompt and then I'll close my Wireshark. Quit without saving. Okay, now let me go back to my switch. We saw that both legit DHCP server and rogue DHCP server are able to offer DHCP parameters to our client. Now let me go to my bridge or my switch. Double click my bridge one and I'll click the DHCP snooping tick box. And as you can see, we got another tab there that says add DHCP option 82. Option 82, it's one of the DHCP options that exist. It's for relay agent. When you enable DHCP option 82, your DHCP won't be able to allocate DHCP parameters. So let me not allocate it. Can I click OK? And then before we can do anything else, I want to show you that DHCP snooping will affect both DHCP servers because all ports inside our bridge are untrusted. So none of the servers will be able to list parameters to our client. So to show you that, let me go to my command prompt again. And then let's see if it already lost the IP address that we got or if it still has it. And then if it still has it, I'm going to release the IP address and renew it and see what IP address we will get. But probably we are going to get an APIPA address as our DHCP servers won't be able to offer parameters to our client. And one more thing, let me open my Wireshark so that we can capture and see what happens on Wireshark. Okay, let me capture packets and then I'll give the command ipconfig, enter. Okay, still has the 192.168.1.254. So let me give ipconfig /release and then I'll do ipconfig /renew, enter. Let's see what IP address will we get. While we are still waiting, let me filter my messages to DHCP. And then as you can see, there's our release message, DHCP release. And then DHCP discover. There's no offer, there's no request, there's no acknowledge. So meaning we are sending discover messages, but they are getting discarded because of DHCP snooping. So let's see what IP address we got. As we can see, it's still hanging. We haven't got an IP address and I'm definitely sure we won't get an IP address or we will get an APIPA address. Okay, let me minimize it. So right now what I'm going to do, I'll go to my ports and then ETH1, I'm going to double click it and then click on trusted tick box and click OK. And now you can see Ethernet 1 is a trusted port. So let's go back to our Wireshark and see what's happening right now. Okay, seems like it's still hanging. Then let me go to my command prompt. As you can see, we got an error occurred while renewing interface Ethernet, unable to contact your DHCP server. Request as timeout. So let me do the renew again, and then let's see. Right now we are probably going to get an IP address, and yes, we got the IP address, which is 10.10.1.253. And if we can go to our Wireshark, we'll see that there's no an offer from 192.168.1 network. As you can see, it's only an offer from 10.10.1.254. And right now, let me go back again to my bridge. Okay, let's make ETH2 trusted and click OK. And we go back to ETH1 and make ETH1 untrusted. Click OK. Right now, ETH2 is trusted. And because we made ETH2 trusted, we are going to get an IP address from our rogue DHCP server. And you'll see on our Wireshark, 10.10.1 network won't appear because it's connected to untrusted port. Okay, let me minimize. Then I'll go to CMD again, ipconfig/release. Then I'll go ipconfig/renew. And as you can see, we got 192.168.1.254. Let me minimize so that we can go to our Wireshark. And on our Wireshark, we can see that 10.10.1 network didn't appear because it's connected to untrusted port. So that's how you block or stop DHCP rogue servers. Hope this was informative and you enjoyed it. And if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button so that you can be notified whenever we drop a new video or a lesson. Have a blessed day. Thank you.